This is your third one already today. How on earth are you not blowing up? How unfair is that? I worked my ass off to lose 1 pound. And by the way, pizza and ice cream? Seriously? Wanna bite?
It was a joke.
Welcome back, guys. Today we talk about a question probably many of us asked ourselves once. Why on earth do some people seem to never gain weight no matter how much they eat? Before we jump into the science, make sure to subscribe and ring the bell for more videos. The answer to this question is not so simple. How much weight a person gains, and I'm talking of course about gaining fat as a result of a calorie surplus, is a combination out of behavioral, nutritional, and genetic factors. Genetics plays of course a significant role in a person's proposition to gain weight, but it's of course not the sole determinant. But when talking about genetics, what do we actually mean? Firstly, the metabolic rate. Each individual has a specific so-called basal metabolic rate, which is the number of calories burned when you rest. Naturally, some people have a faster metabolism, meaning that the food they eat is quicker burned and used for various bodily functions, such as breathing, digestion, blood circulation, or the regulation of your body temperature. In a study from 2019, people were divided into thrifty and spendthrift metabolic phenotypes, measured by the short-term response to fasting and overfeeding. And indeed, people with a spendthrift phenotype also gained less weight. The thermic effect of food also plays a role. If you want to learn more about that, check out this video. Secondly, genetics plays a role how and where your fat is stored. So sometimes it might appear that somebody is not gaining weight because the fat is kind of equally distributed over the whole body. While others have a strong predisposition to store fat at the abdomen, hips, or face. Thirdly, genetics includes hormone regulation, and two hormones are specifically important, and that are ghrelin and leptin. The appetite and hunger hormones. Ghrelin increases your appetite, while leptin makes you feel full. Studies have shown that some obese individuals have imbalances between those hormones, or even leptin resistances, making it much tougher for them to stop eating. Lastly, food preferences and your body's response to exercise are very important. Genetic factors can influence your food preferences and therefore your food of choice. Also, our bodies respond differently to physiological stress or exercise, making it easier or tougher to lose calories while working out. By the way, just as how and where you gain weight depends on your genetics, so is muscle growth. To a certain extent, many proteins and hormonal levels, such as testosterone levels, are determined by your genetics. An important protein called alpha-actinin 3, which is present in so-called fast-twitch muscles, which allows muscles to contract rapidly, is also not really influenceable by you and part of your DNA. As I said, and it's very important for me to mention, genetics is definitely a thing, but it's not destiny. The second biggest factor when it comes to gaining weight is, of course, your lifestyle. The everyday choices you make. In particular, your diet and your level of physical activity. For sure, your diet plays a more important role. I mean, you eat 3 times a day. Or at least 2. If a person with, let's say, bad genetics eats healthy on a daily basis, then one piece of cake will not be the end of the world. For sure. Your body will find its balance. And the cool thing about being a human is that we are extremely adaptive. The lifestyle you will live for a longer period of time will be your new balance. So that means if it's a good one, nothing to worry about. But at the same time, if you have bad habits over a longer period of time, you will see these consequences. Keep an eye on nutritional labels and make conscious and healthy food choices, and also keep your stress and therefore cortisol levels to a minimum. By the way, a study from 2011 could very nicely show that food choices, even when they are small, have a huge impact on your long-term weight gain. We also have to differentiate between being healthy and being fit, because that is mixed up way too often, especially in the fitness industry. Being extraordinary fit is also not your body standard, and it might also not be healthy at all. I want to emphasize that having some pounds plus is nothing to feel bad about. Being healthy and feeling healthy is what we aspire. Well, if you think you're the one with the bad genetics, you can of course blame your parents, God or the world, but at the end of the day, you will gain nothing from that. Except some pounds. Just kidding. I want to say, take control what you can take control of. Genetics is a very poor excuse, which I hear way too often. Oh, my legs are too short, my wrists are too weak, my head is too soft, my d*** is too big. Blah, blah, blah. Don't be that type of person and show your character no matter your genetics. And even if it is harder for you, you are the one who gets stronger through that. So if you have a certain fitness goal, prove yourself and others. Also, what I very often see is that people with apparently good genetics do not train as hard as people with bad genetics. I mean, very often they look very good physically or can do very tough skills because of their genetics. But they rely way too much on it, and that's why at one point they simply stop, because they do not have this work ethic. Compared to someone who is used to fighting his whole life to lose 1 kilogram of fat. Keep in mind, hard work almost always beats talent and genetics. One last thing I want to add is that sometimes the phenomenon of someone not gaining weight might just be perception, especially if you don't know that person very well. While it might look that Vitaly eats more shit, he actually did have as much for breakfast as Victor. Victor, though, keeps his meals and calorie intake more or less the same. So the total calorie intake of both is more or less the same. Well, how healthy Vitaly eats is another topic. To sum it up, it's not only about genetics. Of course, genetics plays a huge role, but it's also a combination out of your lifestyle and food choices. And all of that, at the end of the day, makes you look how you look. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'm really curious what you think about this topic. What experiences did you make? Write it down in the comments below. Stay healthy and see you next time.